What's going on? This is the long version of the Fisher 203. We didn't do a video of this, and we basically haven't sold it because we undermined it severely. We didn't have anything to show for it. So here we have the Fisher 203. This is a solid state receiver. This thing sounds really good, really great, nice, warm sound, very good bass reproduction. It's a solid one for sure. We've got Kate Bush up on the ones and twos up here, and we've got this thing here so that we can actually set this, the PSX5 up there, and then we've got a cassette. We've got Top Gun on the cassette. So we're gonna run through each of the different ports. We've got a Alex device on our aux port here, and we've tested both aux ports. They both work great, but we're just gonna show you them working. Let's get to the, let's see here, we got bass, let's put that at zero, treble at that, balance, we got the volume down a little bit. We don't have loudness on, high filter. So we'll go through all those different things on this, and so you can see it working. And yeah, we'll probably take the turntable off eventually at some point. So let's just get it going. We're right now, let's hit it on the phono, little Kate Bush. What do we got going on, Kate Bush? Oh, that's not the phono. Is it the phono? There we go. There's the phono. Let's run that all the way up. So we have this on the main. So you can do remote, main plus remote. So you can have both speakers going at once. And then you have phones, so I guess that would be headphones. Let's see how that works. I don't know if you can hear that. Got these little grottos. Alright, so we're gonna turn that back down. And remote, so those work because the mains are connected. Make a deal with God. There's the bass. There's loudness. You can definitely feel that coming. High filter. Tape monitor obviously shuts it all down. So pull this back a little bit. Because when I switch over to the radio, it gets really loud. Don't know if you can hear that, the difference in this audio, but you can definitely hear the bass on that. AM. Here's the aux. Let's see if we can get something playing on the aux. It's kind of like, let's get this going here. Difference, but man, it definitely is nice. So there's that. Everything works on this. Looks great. Lights look great on this. I mean, it's one. I mean, audio guys knew what they were doing, man. Back in the day. So we're gonna get everything dismantled here. I'm gonna flip this around so you can see the back of it. See what's going on back there. And oh, let's do tape real quick. I don't think we do the tape yet. I think I have that plugged into. Where do I have the tape plugged in? It's a great question. Let's try this. There it is. it's playing. You can see the little, this thing though going here. Time to start off. Boom. That's pretty cool. That's fun. And you got the little audio, the VU meters there going. So this is going up in our store too. This is the Akai. Let's just let that play while we're dismantling the turntable. Piece of dust on that needle. I forgot, I'm gonna take this down. I went ahead and flip this around just to, and as you hear the tape coming back on, that means it's plugged into here. So, turns off, right, it's switched. There we go, comes back on. So you know that works. We've got this plugged into the main speaker, left and right. You can have up to 4 speakers on this running at the same time. And we've got our tape going into here. And we've done everything else here too, the phono, that's where we had the record player plugged in, we had the aux, we've already tested those ports. So Fisher 203 AM FM stereo receiver, and solid piece of equipment right here. Sounds really nice and warm. So go and find it in our store. Thanks for watching, guys, and yeah, great looking receiver for your house.